Welcome to my mind, let me take you on a field trip. This that realness, now let me show you what I deal with. If you look to the left, yeah, you can see my pride. Look how I despise and look down on other guys. God hates a proud look, but you can see it in my eyes. And how in my own eyes, I just think I'm so wise. Satan told me I was special, I believe the lies. Who me? End up in hell? No, I believe in God. You can see self-righteousness if you look to the right. How I started looking to myself and stopped looking to Christ. Started living like God's love depends on my own merits. And if I fell in sin, felt like I wasn't cherished. The Pharisees trusted themselves and they surely perished. Sometimes I trust in myself, I'm just being transparent. My sins out in the open, I'm being so outspoken. But it's in Jesus who I place my hope in, yeah.
Welcome to my life, where you can see all the blindness. I'll let you see all the prideful stuff that's in my heart. Welcome to my life, where you can see that there's bitterness. I'll let you see that deceitfulness that's in my heart.
You can see my lust if you look to the right. How I was looking at other women besides my wife. That's not loving her like the church is loved by the Christ. I need covenant eyes. I struggle with my sight. There's enough porn in my mind to last a lifetime. Explicit images still calling me at nighttime. Take a glance over here, you can see the lies. Not being accountable to the brethren is never wise. And now I'm staring at the man in the mirror, bruh. It's no wonder they starting to doubt my character. And over here are my thoughts full of violence. Man, I'm so afraid, I got the rage of a pirate. Yeah, you hear that violin? That's the sound of my sadness. Me not casting my burdens on Jesus is complete madness. My sins out in the open, I'm being so outspoken. But it's in Jesus who I place my hope in, yeah.
Welcome to my life, where you can see.
Welcome back to Aaron the Addisons. This is Urban Family Talk. We're so glad you're listening. Appreciate you sticking around. I'm Miki.
And I'm Will. That's Javon McKenzie. Welcome to my life.
Who?
Javon McKenzie.
One day it'd be good to talk to him.
Hey, I think we'd get the opportunity right now.
Was that a cheesy segue?
Yeah, it was.
You know, it's one of those things where a person goes into a dream sequence and they're like, I can't imagine that ever happening. And then the next thing you know, you're in a dream sequence. Right. It would just be so good to talk to Javon McKenzie on a Friday. And if we happen to have him on the line, it'd be good to talk to him about his most recent project, Seduction of Self. But alas, that could never happen.
And then bing.
Well, I'm waiting for you for that.
Oh.
Is he?
Yeah, he's here, man.
Javon McKenzie, welcome to Aaron the Addisons. How you doing?
I'm blessed. How y'all doing? Thanks for having me.
Oh, man, it's our pleasure. We love talking with artists. We love talking with people who are biblically sound. And I'll say this. We even like talking to people who are not biblically sound because it helps us combat a lot of foolishness. So anyway, welcome to the show. Why don't you tell our listening audience a little bit about yourself? We know that you are an independent recording artist. We know that you've had some major struggle in your life and you know, you write about that. You do that very well. So tell our listeners where in the world you are right now, kind of where you hail from, and a little bit of your testimony.
Okay. My name is, of course, Javon McKenzie. I currently live in Columbus, Georgia. I go to Berean Covenant Church. I'm married. I have a son. And I've been married. I'm about to go on 6 years in March.
Okay.
So praise God for that. And so pretty much what I do, I'm a full-time recording artist, independent. I'm pretty much an evangelist, and I do music. And so those are pretty much like my occupations on a day-to-day basis. And so, yeah, by God's grace, I was, you know, I grew up in a, I guess I could say a Christian home in the sense that we went to church, but it wasn't a practical, true, converted home. So my mother, you know, she would take us to church every now and then, but it was never really real. I always believed that Jesus was Lord in the sense of, you know, that he was the Son of God, but it never affected my life. And so I grew up, I learned how to rap at the age of 16 or 17. Mm-hmm. And of course, since I was lost, I was doing the type of music that lost people do.
Yeah.
And especially when it comes to rap, so I was degrading women and talking about guns and, you know, just dumb stuff. Even some stuff I wasn't doing, I would throw in there. And by God's grace, I joined the military, and I joined it because me and my mother, we had a rough relationship, and I just wanted to get out the house, and I was real disrespectful and stuff like that. I didn't know anything about honor. Mm-hmm. I hated authority. So I joined the military, which, you know, of course, I hate authority. So
wow.
You know, it's just kind of like, hey, you know, you kind of think, do I want to be with my mom or do I want to go out here? So
right.
Got into some trouble, just being rebellious. At that time, I believe the Lord started working on my heart. I knew that I needed Christ. But at the same time, I grew up in church, so I kind of felt like I knew I wasn't living right, but I still kind of felt like I would go to heaven. Because, you know, I said the sinner's prayer,
wow.
You know, I would pray every night, Lord, forgive me, stuff like that. But mm-hmm. I knew something wasn't right. I knew I was dishonoring God. So long story short, like Romans 2:4 says that the goodness of God leads us to repentance.
Amen.
And it was just a thing where I just got in so much trouble where I really saw God was my only way out. And I saw that his kindness allowed me to still be alive in the midst of that. And I knew I wasn't living right. And then that's in late 2006 is when I really just cried out to the Lord. And I believe that's when he saved me.
Man, amen.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
That's awesome.
Now, I want you to tell our audience a little bit about your, I guess, if you will, your musical platform and kind of what you seek to do. Because I'm reading here, just kind of looking at your bio, and you said that you believe there's two types of Christians who do art. Those who do art from the church and those who do art for the church. And that you're seeking to have a more consistent balance and blending the two. And so that's what you're looking to do. Can you kind of explain that as your platform?
Yes. Well, currently, as people know me, I've always done just straight up in your face evangelism.
Mm-hmm.
And not every song is evangelistic, but the majority of it is just telling people who Christ is, teaching about the Bible. And by God's grace, I want to continue to do that. I think that's what, you know, personally, that's my conviction. I think, you know, everybody should do that. But I see some artists and there are some good points. Like I know me personally, you know, every song that I listen to is not, quote unquote, a Christian song. There may be some songs that have a good message that's not going against scripture. That's like, hey, I'm a Christian, but right now I want to enjoy the show or the song. Or, you know, I'm a Christian, but hey, I might want to watch Family Matters.
Mm-hmm.
Or I might want to watch, you know, and that's not talking about Christ, but it's a show that, you know, that I may watch. So I think there can be a balance where it's like, hey, you know, every song on my album, like on my next album, every song you hear, every song won't be, quote unquote, you know, like, man, this is, he telling you to repent on every song, but mm-hmm. over on the course of the album, you're going to clearly get who Christ is. You're going to clearly get repentance. You'll know he's the only way to heaven. If you're a lost person, you'll clearly hear about your sin,
mm-hmm.
But you may not hear it on every song, but you won't leave away confused, like, oh, man, he's a Christian, or, oh, man, I didn't know he was telling me to repent. Like, it'll be clear. But so I just want to kind of have, like, a blend of that to where I'm giving people truth, but every song, it may be, like, one song, it may be, like, hey, the kids are away, me and my wife are going to have date night, you
mm-hmm.
know what I'm saying? And then the next song, it might be, like, hey, repent and turn from sin, you know what I'm saying? So I'm just trying to find, like a good balance between that, just being artistic, but at the same time, keeping scriptures in mind as well.
So really kind of just, like, living, like how we live. Like, you know, we are Christians, and that should permeate everything that we do. It's not that you're just a Christian on Sunday, but you're a Christian in every aspect, every area of your life. And so that's what you're kind of wanting to get across in your music. Now let me ask you this, because, you know, there are a lot of artists who sort of started making that shift, you know, and you know where, you may already know where I'm going to go with this and some of the questions. I mean, because if anybody is keeping up with the world of Christian hip hop, then, you know, there's some controversy a brewing. So my question is, When you think about making that shift, do you feel like there are any artists that maybe you kind of look at and you say, yeah, this is kind of how I want to do it? Or, yeah, I'm doing this, but I'm not going to do it like that. Does that make sense?
Yes, man. That's actually a really good question. I would say this. One of the artists I really look up to that I really admire is Flame. I love what he does. He's, every album, he's consistent with the gospel. Now, his sound may change. He's gone to more of a pop, you know, commercial sound,
and
I guess if you could say that in a sense. But his message is still the same. He's still Christ. death, burial, and resurrection. And even when you look at him in his interviews, he's very clear on where he stands doctrinally.
Yes.
on Fox News, you know, he's not shying away from, hey, I'm just a regular guy. Like, no, I'm a Christian. Christ is, you know, Christ is Lord. So, in the direction that, you know, that I see people going, I guess in the direction of where, like you said, everyday life, which is great, but I see a lot of danger in people doing that, because it's almost like they're taking it from one, you know, they're saying, well, it's an extreme because all I did was every song was evangelistic, so that's not real. So now I'm going to go to another unreal where it's like I never really addressed.
Wow. Mm. Yeah.
And then they're saying, so a lot of these artists, I would honestly like to ask them, what do they think evangelism is?
Mm-hmm.
You know,
wow,
because when
good.
I hear the interviews and I see, you know, I listen to a lot of the songs that they say are quote unquote for the lost, mm-hmm. for the world to hear. There's nothing that I've heard personally that makes me think like, wow, like if I was lost, man, I would have been convicted and know that God was holy and that judgment day is coming. You know, so I definitely don't see anybody, and that's why I was talking about earlier about having that blend.
Yes.
I think there's a way you can have that balance while still remaining faithful like me. I personally would rather somebody put out just a positive album, and when you talk to them in their interviews and they're around sinners, you know that they're clearly all about the gospel, because mm-hmm. it's having somebody who kind of seems like they're about the gospel.
Mm-hmm.
But then when you really hear their interviews or when you see them around, you know, different artists or whatever, it kind of just seems like they're not really about what they say in their music.
Wow.
Man,
wow.
Brilliant.
You know,
thank you so much for that. I really appreciate it. You know, we're at this place where we just want to talk to real people. We don't want to talk to people who are kind of like trying to cover for other people or trying to make excuses or even give sort of the, you know, the benefit of the doubt to that person's detriment. So that's really refreshing. I appreciate that, Javon. Will, you go right ahead.
No, I was going to say he mentioned Flame, and we had a chance to interview Flame. It was, you know, we appreciate his music and ministry also. And the thing is, one statement that he made, you know, we thought was pretty provocative. He said that he feels like if there's artists out there who have been Christian artists, you know, for a while, and now they feel like they want to make a shift, he was saying that he felt like maybe they need to totally just kind of get out the way so that Christian artists that want to keep that label as Christian rappers can have those slots. What would you say about that? Is that something that you agree with? Or?
I actually personally was talking to some brothers. I won't name any names,
sure.
But I personally, we were kind of saying the same thing. Like, I personally just wish that, you know, like some of these guys that are taking the Christian label off, I'm like, hey, praise God, that's fine.
Mm-hmm.
let's let there not be no confusion on who is a Christian artist and who's not. You know, like, hey, if you're going to be a Christian artist, don't be a Christian artist when you're in front of Christians, and then when you're in the world, you're just an artist.
Ooh,
you know,
Wow.
Have it consistent. So I would love to see that, you know, because my main thing is this. You know, we all know that Barack Obama's our president, right?
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if all of us, let's say you guys and me, we went to Barack Obama, summoned us to his office, and he said, hey, how can we change this country? And let's say we told him from Scripture, how we should run this country according to God's laws, right?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And let's say that Barack Obama was like, hey, that's true, and we told him about the gospel. Let's say he repented and sent us out, and now we're on CNN, and they're asking us about this.
Mm-hmm.
You know, hey, how are we going to change? We wouldn't try to hide the fact that Obama sent us out. Why? Because he's the president. What are we ashamed of?
Right.
So,
right.
Because Christ is king, Christ is reigning right now. If I'm sitting down with a sinner, if I'm sitting down with an interview and questions clearly come up or different things come up, then I don't have to be ashamed that, well, maybe they're not going to like what I'm saying. I don't want to be offensive. I'm sent by the king.
So if I'm
sent by Obama, I'm not going to be afraid of what Republicans are going to say or what. No, because I'm with Obama. I'm with, you know, so if we're with the king, then I believe we should represent and we should have that boldness by God's grace, like you see in Acts, that guess what? We represent the king. We're ambassadors. So since we're ambassadors, we shouldn't be ashamed of, you know, if the world calls me a Christian artist or the world calls me a Bible thumper. Like I said something on my new song. I said, you know, they say I'm lacking wisdom. You know, I say that's pragmatism. And they say I'm too preachy. I say they're too sneaky. I said I don't want to be no Bible thumper. I just don't want to see you when your idol's comforted.
Wow.
Ooh,
come on.
that's my stance by the grace of God. So I believe that there's, like Flame, I think Flame said it a while ago, about, you know, we should just have some dialogue, you know, the guys that believe this way and the guys that believe, like, the other way. And just, you know, just search the scriptures, because anybody can say, well, I believe this, or, mm-hmm. you know, even like doing songs with secular artists, like, where does it stop? Mm. You know, how far, who can't we do a song with?
Right.
That's my biggest question.
Man.
Right. You know.
Okay, well, you know what? I don't know if we have time. I think we're coming up on a break.
We can explore it after the break.
Okay, then we'll mm-hmm. do the break, because I'm glad that you brought that up, actually, Javon, mm-hmm. because, you know, we have a clip that we're going to play for you, and we just wanted to get your reaction to it. Just, you know, and
okay.
and again, we're not trying to put people on the spot, but we'll hold it over because yeah. we're coming up on a break here. And we'll just play it when we get back. But I really appreciate what you're saying. And so let's do this, though. Let's kind of make a segue. We just got a question. You can live chat with us if you're listening online.
Go to the Churbin.
We call it the Churbin.
Urban chat.
You go to urbanfamilytalk.com, and we just got a question in the Churbin. Are y'all taking any calls? We'd gladly take your calls.
Yes.
Let me give you the number.
Calls.
It's 866-963-2037. If you've got a question for Javon, you want to, you know, ask him about some of his positions or whatever, that's great. We'd appreciate hearing from you. I'm sure that he would appreciate hearing from you. 866-963-2037. We're just about coming up on a break. Now, the new project is called Seduction of Self. Can people go to JavonMcKenzie.com?
Yes, they can go to JavonMcKenzie.com, and they can download that along with four other albums, and they're all available for free download.
Oh, man, that's awesome. Okay, well, let me make sure that our listeners get this. So JavonMcKenzie.com, that's JOVANMACKENZY. JOVANMACKENZY, JavonMcKenzie.com. You can go there and check it out. Get this project. You know, the thing is, whenever you talk to an artist like we're doing right now, and you yeah. really get to hear that artist's heart, it changes the way you listen to their music.
Yes.
Because
yes.
you go, okay, that was not just for the rhyme.
Right.
That's true conviction. And
Amen.
So I really appreciate that. We come back more with Javon McKenzie. We're going to get into why he entitled this recent project Seduction of Self. You're listening to Aaron the Addisons on Urban Family Talk. Stay close.
I gotta mortify. I can't wait until I'm glorified. Yeah. Don't want you now. Don't need you now. You have me bound.
We're back. This is Aaron the Addisons on Urban Family Talk. We're so glad that you're listening. 866-963-2037 if you have a question or comment. 866-963-2037. Our amazing producer, Dainty C, will put you through. I'm Miki.
And I'm Will. That was Javon McKenzie, Don't Want You Now. He said, when the dark night rises, that's when those Christians bail. Christian Bale, Dark Knight,
oh,
Batman. Man, look.
Stop.
I'm talking bars.
Stop,
bars.
Man.
You got bars, man.
Man,
you gotta listen.
I know. I'm sorry.
You gotta see what he did. Look.
I know.
Look
I know. I'm sorry. See, that's when it pays to not just be into the beat. Everybody's like, no, I don't listen to the words. I just like the beat. That's what we used to tell my mom when we was growing up. Mm. We're not listening to what he's saying, mama.
Yeah.
We just listening to the beat.
Yeah, right.
Mom,
yeah.
You gotta listen to the beat. Yeah. We were just so misled, trying to be like slick. You know, mm-hmm. my mom be like, that's garbage. Anyway, I'm sorry. I went back into my old ways.
That's all right. I'm here to help you.
Thank you. Javon McKenzie, man, bars. And they're not chocolate. Not chocolate.
They're not chocolate.
Joining us on Aaron the Addisons. And it's just real talk right now. We're just talking about the state of Christian hip hop. And I appreciate anybody who can give me an honest answer. The Seiko might call it answering like a man.
You know? yeah.
Anybody, you can ask them a question. They can look you straight in the eye and give you an answer without kind of like trying to skirt around issues and stuff. Mm-hmm. And I really appreciate that. Before we went to break, we kind of ventured into talking about collaborating. We've talked about that a lot on this show.
Yes, we have. We have.
We've talked about what we see happening. Look, with Reach Records, I'm just going to be honest.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of people like to kind of skirt around issues. We interviewed Lecrae.
Yeah.
15 minutes.
Yeah.
15 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
He said he's going to come back, though.
Yeah. Okay.
I believe him.
And we asked some tough questions. We asked some tough questions.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
we even mentioned that there are some people who are saying if you want to move away from mm-hmm. the label of being a Christian rapper,
yeah.
why not just go ahead and move out of that spot?
Right.
You know, and he said it's more complicated than that.
Yeah.
He said you don't, you know, have a biologist, you know, need to be called a Christian biologist. He's just working. He's just doing his work. And, you know, and I understand that.
Yeah,
I do.
Yeah,
I understand that. You
yeah,
know,
but that's
but the problem that we've had and the question that I want to ask Javon here mm-hmm. and we're going to go into go into this clip.
Mm hmm.
You know, where should a Christian draw the line when we start talking about these collaborations and we start talking about, you know, kind of being like doe-eyed about these artists that we'd like to work with. And I want to run this clip here. And then when we come out of this clip, Javon, I just want to get your perspective on it. This is a an interview that Andy Mineo is doing. And he's asked a particular question. And, well, you can just hear it in the clip here. Go ahead, Will.
What do you look forward to? Is there anybody that you'd like to work with? Are there any dream collaborations? Somebody that you really think you might be able to cook up something really interesting with, who may be Christian-based or otherwise?
Yeah. Yeah, man. I'd love to get in a room with Kanye at some point, have a conversation, you know what I mean, and see something cooks up. I'm inspired by, you know, his, obviously, he's like a legend already, you know what I'm saying, and his track record's amazing, and I think he's in a unique place in his faith, you know what I'm saying, his faith journey with Yeezus and seeing his live show. I'm like, what's up? What's going on with you, man? And it's always kind of been there a little bit, but it seems more so now. You hear in his interviews, he says stuff like, my new mission is I want to honor God. I want to please God. And you're like, I never heard that in your interviews before, but it's popping up more. And it's so I think it'd be a great conversation, and obviously a collaboration out of that would be dope. But so many dudes, man. I look up to J. Cole's a beast. I think that'd be some interesting conversations to see what that turns into. I think... my interaction my presence in hip-hop, if we're able to mix it up, will lead to some good conversations, probably some good music too, because a lot of these dudes grew up in churches, a lot of these dudes, you know what I'm saying, have some kind of history, but they refuse to talk about it, and that might create some space for us to talk about it on records, and you know, I think that'd be really cool to see happen in hip-hop.
If you just tuned in, this is Aaron the Addisons on Urban Family Talk. You heard the voice of Andy Mineo, who's on the Reach Records
label. Mm-hmm.
And he was asked the question point blank, who would you like to work with, Christian or otherwise?
Right.
To me, that's given, like, that's helping you. That's a way of escape.
Yeah.
That's a way of escape. You weren't, you know. So anyway, right now we've got independent recording artist Javon McKenzie. We're talking about his new project, Seduction of Self. But I just wanted to get your opinion on that. When you hear that clip and you hear what's being said, what immediately comes to mind for you?
It's so much to take in. You know, I definitely love Andy. I love
sure.
his music. I've never met him personally.
Right.
I don't think we've even talked on the internet or anything, but I support his album that he came with. I think it's Heroes for Sale. It's a really good album.
Yeah.
Just judging that clip alone, there's just a few things that throw me off. Number one, he said that, you know, Kanye's in a unique spot in his faith, and, you know, he seems like he's moving closer or something like that. Well, correct me if I'm wrong, I know as far as me, you know, I was a super idolater in the world.
Mm-hmm.
So when you talk about Kanye, Jay-Z, you know, you pretty much name anybody, I can probably give you word-for-word lyrics. And the last time I checked, was Kanye's last album, was it College Dropout or was it Yeezus?
Most recent?
Yeah, it was Yeezus, right?
Yeah.
Because last time I checked, College Dropout was the first album he did,
mm-hmm.
and that was most conscious or positive, if you want to call it that. You know, he cursed every now and then.
Mm-hmm.
He wasn't talking about degrading women. You know, he was talking about actual stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And anybody that clearly looks at hip-hop would see that Kanye did a drastic change, especially mm-hmm. when his mom died.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So you listen to Yeezus, you listen to some of these other records where he talks about, you know, Jesus and fornicating and just nonsense, just real blasphemy.
Right.
So, you know, so there's nothing good in the flesh, that's what Paul said. So
mm-hmm.
Kanye, you know, there's no, I put on my Facebook the other day, there's no neutrality.
Right.
You know, you're either for Christ or you're against Christ. And since Kanye, you know, I don't have to know Kanye personally to see by his lifestyle of fornication. You know, he's supposedly got another baby on the way. You know, his lyrics are clearly blasphemous and totally against God. His attitude, everything about him, nothing about him says regeneration.
Mm-hmm.
So his art is clearly against God.
Right.
So he felt the faith that he has is not salvific faith. So there is no faith.
Yeah.
You know, and the Bible says whatever is not a faith is sin. So, you know, that strikes me, number one. Number two is, you know, the whole, you know, man, maybe we can get a collab. And, you know, a lot of artists, what I'm noticing now is people are trying to use Chick-fil-A, and these other companies will say, well, Chick-fil-A is a Christian company and they serve pagans, or they, you know, they serve sinners. So, well, what's the difference if I put Kanye on a song? Well, number one, me serving feeding the sinners is what the Bible commands me to do.
Right, right.
You know, and me serving sinners shows that I'm loving my enemies. It also shows that I'm loving, you know, my neighbor.
Mm-hmm.
So that's love, but me giving somebody a burger or a sinner cooking a burger doesn't have a worldview.
Mm-hmm.
But when I put you on a song, it does have a worldview.
Mm-hmm.
And and it's not even just like they're putting somebody lost on their song that just does great positive music. You're putting somebody in your song who clearly goes against scripture.
Yeah.
Right.
And another thing I thought of was, you know, from the interviews that I've seen Kanye, as arrogant as Kanye is about his you know, his spot in hip hop and about greatness, he would probably never do a song with Andy Mineo in the first place.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
You know, he would look at him like, you're nobody.
Mm-hmm.
You know, right. To me, you know, from my angle, I'm like, man, Andy Mineo's selling a lot. To Kanye, he would look at him like, come on.
Right.
Right.
Is a little embarrassing for us in the faith. It's a little embarrassing because what it appears to be is sort of like this Bambi effect where, you know, it's this Twitter-pated. I'm so, you know, and Thumper and it's just like butterflies flying around and like, you know, Kanye. I mean,
yeah.
It just, to me, it's almost like, man, really? Like Lecrae, I mean, you're mentoring this. Like, this is what is going on. And honestly, that's a problem. But I tell you what, let's segue because we're running out of time so fast. And I hate that the time keeps going, but I don't want to not talk about Seduction of Self, because I think that what we see happening in Christian hip hop right now has a lot to do with being enamored by oneself and one's own success. And you kind of speak to some of those issues in the project. So let's talk about that.
Okay. Yeah. Seduction of Self. I named that title. Pretty much just a lot of this stuff, not just with the Christian rap, but just stuff in general, false teachers, tares in the church, all kind of stuff. You know, you can get wrapped, you can get caught up in that as far as you can make that your life to where now you just wake up every day and you're purposely looking for false teachers, or you're purposely looking about what this artist said or what this artist said. And so I really wanted to do, at the time I was like, man, I got so much of my own sin, I need to look at self.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and as I started looking at self, I'm like, man, self is jacked up as well.
Wow.
So I'm like, okay, like even like you played the Andy Mineo clip, I believe he dropped the ball. You know, I'm pretty sure many would disagree with me. I believe a lot of these artists, when they get in these interviews on MTV, I believe they drop the ball.
Uh-huh.
And,
yeah.
You know, people can hear me say that and be like, oh, you think you're better or you're just this. And I'm like, well, if you actually knew me, you would know I think I'm worse.
Wow.
You know, I look at my life and I'm like, by God's grace, I see sanctification. I'm loving my wife. I'm doing these things. At the same time, I still see so much pride. I still see so much self-righteousness. I still see so much false humility. I still see so much compromise in my own self where I'm like, hey, like, Lord, just keep me. You know what I'm saying? Just make sure I'm not deceived. You know, so I'm always trying to look at myself more than I am anybody else. You know, so as much as I'm disappointed in that interview, I'm always disappointed in myself because I know I constantly miss the mark of God.
Man.
So Seduction of Self was just a thing like, okay, I see all this stuff going around. But the album I did before that was called Famine, which was, you know, a lot of it was dealing with false teachers in the church. And I had a skull on the album, which represented, you know, a famished land.
Mm-hmm.
And also I have a skull in the mirror on my new album.
Yeah, I saw that.
Which is showing, huh?
No, I saw that. Yeah, that's good. Go ahead.
And what it represents is I'm looking in the mirror and I'm seeing that same skull. I'm seeing there's a famine in me. Like, hey,
wow.
I haven't been praying. I haven't been reading the word like I should. I haven't been loving my neighbor like I should. I've been getting irritated with my wife, stuff like that. So it's like, man, yes, there's definitely a famine in the church and there's a lot of false teachers. At the same time, Lord, correct this famine in me. You know, help me to seek your face. Help me to, you know, because you can start looking at so many other people and you start to forget your own sin.
Man, it's
and so
true.
How Jesus says, take the speck out of your eye and the plank out of your eye before you try to take it out of your brother's eye. And so that's what I wanted to do on this album. I just wanted to show people, like, yes, I'm always by God's grace. I'm not going to be like Peter and be like, man, I'll never do what they do. Like, no, I could fall tomorrow and compromise even worse than what they're doing. But I believe, you know, by God's grace, it's like, hey, you know, I'm looking at my own heart. As much as I see what's going on, it's like, I'm not trying to purposely look for stuff. You know, like people will play stuff for me to be like, hey, man, what do you think about this? And like I'll answer. But at the end of the day, Martin Luther said it best. He said, you know, I am more afraid of my own heart than the Pope and all his cardinals, because in my heart lies the true Pope, which is self.
Wow.
And so wow. I look at that. As much I look at the Creflo Dollars, I look at these guys, I look at some of these rappers who I believe are to a certain extent compromising, and I'm like, yeah, that's wrong, but if you see my heart, you'll really see wrong. You know what I'm saying? So I'm always trying to keep that in perspective so that way I can show grace and not just be like, oh, man, these guys are just crazy and I'm better than them and I would never do it. It's like, no, by God's grace, I pray.
Amen.
I never do that. You know what I'm saying? So that's kind of how the album spurred, just to show like, hey, let's remember while we're judging our brothers, which we need to, Scripture calls us to, let's make sure more than anybody we're hard on ourselves than we are others.
Very well said. Javon McKenzie has been our guest for this hour. We've been talking about his most recent project, Seduction of Self. Let me just ask you this as we, you know, wrap up in this last minute. There are a lot of these, you know, Christian artists who sort of, they've kind of surpassed the church. They're moving away from the church. Are you still available for ministry to young people in the church?
Oh, yeah, definitely, all the time.
Okay, so how can people find out about you if they want to bring you to their youth group or to their church and do an outreach event?
They can go to my website, JavonMcKenzie.com, and just click on booking, and they can book me there.
And
bring me out and stuff like that. I'm always available to churches or anywhere where I can go. I always tell people, wherever I go, by God's grace, if I can preach the gospel, I'll go.
Amen. Javon McKenzie, JavonMcKenzie.com. We have a great need for truth nowadays.